Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let me show you how to share your iTunes media with other users on your network. So this has got to be one of the most common questions I get asked. People have lots of music stored on their Mac and they want to save it on, say, a network drive in their house and have those same files be used by multiple Macs. So in other words, you have one copy of an MP3 file and you can use that on two or more Macs in your house. So the way to do that, of course, is to put the music on some sort of network drive. It could be a drive attached to an iMac or some computer that's always on. It could be a drive attached to your AirPort Extreme. Could be some sort of network server that you've got. And you have that drive accessible to all the Macs in your house. Now you can put your iTunes music on that drive and have it used in iTunes libraries on all the different Macs as long as you check one little box in iTunes. So in iTunes, I'm going to go to iTunes Preferences and I'm going to go to the Advanced tab, and there I have got the option Copy Files to iTunes Media Folder when Adding to Library. And this is the critical one. When you add something to your iTunes library, it will then appear there in the music folder. So a physical copy will be made and put there. And this means that all of your music, everything you add to iTunes, is going to be in this one location available to the one user on your one Mac. Turn this off, it will stop doing this, which means you can add music that will then stay where it was and be available in iTunes. It will just link to the file externally. So you can have one copy on a shared drive and you can have two users on your network link to that same file, and it won't copy to either one of those. You've got to turn that off in every copy of iTunes where you're going to do this. So now if I look at my music in here, I can control click on anything that I want and go Show in Finder. And it will bring up a Finder window, and in this case I can see that this song is in a subfolder inside my Music folder, inside my iTunes Media folder, inside of iTunes, inside my Music folder, inside of my User folder. So this is exactly where I don't want it because it's available just to me. I want to share this. So what I want to do is if I go up here to this level, I can see I've got four different artists here in my Music folder. I want to take these and I want to move these, copy them to somewhere else. So in this case, I've got this other drive here, and this could be a shared drive or an attached drive. Let's pretend it's a shared drive, and I'm going to move all this. I already have an artist there and some music stored there. I'm going to copy all the music to it. So now I've got copies on this shared drive here, as well as my originals still in place, and the originals here are what's linked in iTunes. So now if I go over to iTunes once this is done copying, then I can select all of the songs here, Command A, and I'm going to hit the Delete key. And I'm going to make sure, of course, that I've finished copying them all over, and I'm going to hit Delete Songs. And this is going to clear out my iTunes library. I'm going to say Move to Trash because I want to actually clean these out of that music folder. So now when I go back to the Finder here, I can see that in the iTunes Media folder, all that stuff is gone. So I have nothing in there. I've got nothing in iTunes, but I have the copies that I made here on the shared drive. Now, since I have actually turned off the check mark for copy, I can now select these and drag them back in iTunes, and watch how quickly it adds them because it's not making a copy of them. It actually added them without copying them into the music folder. That's still empty. So each one of these is a link to the location here, and this could be a shared drive. So I can do the same thing on another iTunes, on another Mac, also connected to the same network drive, add all the files, and the actual files will only be in one place even though I see them in two different iTunes libraries. Now if you buy new music in iTunes, it's going to of course put them in your iTunes Media folder. But what you can do is just repeat that process. Just move them to the shared drive, remove them from iTunes, and then add them back from that shared drive. So that way you can keep all your music in one location. You can of course actually divide things up. You can keep some things in a shared location and let some things be in your local user folder. Now the big question is, what happens if that drive isn't connected? I've disconnected that drive now and I'm going to run iTunes. So it's not going to be able to find any of these songs. Now nothing will seem wrong at first, but what's going to happen is if I double click to play, it's going to say it can't find it. Now I've reconnected that drive, and let's see what happens when I hit cancel and then I try to play it. You see, it will work. Now, I've always had great success with that, with just reconnecting the drive and everything links back fine. But there are plenty of reports of people having trouble once it says it can't find it, and even if the drive becomes available, they have to relink each individual file. Maybe that's just with older versions of iTunes, and that's something that just doesn't happen if you have everything up to date. But it is something to keep in mind. Of course, one thing to consider is that by removing everything from iTunes and adding it back from another location, you're going to lose all your star ratings, all your number of plays, and even the playlist won't work quite right anymore. So you're going to have to recreate all of those. Now, if you're starting from scratch, this is great to do. And of course, if you need to implement this, then you're just going to have to do it. But it is something to keep in mind. Another thing that you've got to deal with here is if you're using this, then iTunes is giving up on helping you organize your files. So as you create this music folder on a shared drive, it's up to you to organize it. It's up to you to actually have good file names, good folder structure, put it all together, and have it make some sense. So I hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.